So welcome everybody to our deep dives into process automation when it comes to water treatment. And we're broadcasting live here right out of the production halls of GF Piping Systems. What a wonderful place this is. You probably could like to come to work here.
Yeah, I like it. I enjoy to work here, of course, yeah.
Now, process automation in general, for me as a layman, is something I'm not so familiar with. What would you say is it all about?
And exactly that is what we want to show you, to you now, and to everybody who has no idea about process automation in the water treatment sector. And we want to show this on a real skit, and we produced this skit based on a real project what we had in the Middle East. So it's exactly what you would see when you go to a water treatment plant in the Middle East.
Sounds interesting. And all these parts we see here on display, they all play a role? Like what would this be?
Yes, so all the products, what you can see, they play a role in a water treatment skid. Mm-hmm. You can see here a ball valve, a butterfly valve, the flow termag, and the different actuators, which are used to actuate the valves itself.
So basically, process automation would mean the perfect interplay of all products.
Exactly. So all these products, additional, also the pipes and the fittings, everything what GF offers helped our customers to make their best water treatment skid ever.
Okay, I think I'm getting a better picture of what it's about, but what if you have to convince somebody? Process automation is the right thing if you want more what? Efficiency, transparency, what does it help your customer actually do and get?
Yeah, I think that are the keywords, efficiency and also the interaction between the different actuators, the different sensors. So that you need to go every time to your water treatment skid. If there's a failure, maybe you can read it out and you can check from everywhere if everything is working smooth or not.
So to kind of like transition to a more automated process, you could say, is it important to have everything right from the start, or is there a way to like kind of like gradually build it up, like a start small and then just grow as I go along?
That's always possible, right? So maybe you recognize after a time that the water treatment is not big enough, skid is not big enough, and then you can add other components to the skid. That's always possible.
Sounds good.
And we as GF always help our customers to make such projects happen. We are a system solution provider, and we also help our customers to customize the skid itself. So GF is a partner and help our customers.
So they're in the right hands, that's for sure.
Yeah.
And you were talking about the example, the video, the skit.
Yeah.
You brought a video along?
Yeah, of course. So all our product experts, so the product managers from the different parts, what you can see here, they will explain how the product itself help at each area in the skid to produce pure water.
All right, well, then let's check this out. And to give us more details, we're now joined by the segment manager for water treatment for the sales company Germany, Cyrus. Take it away.
Hi. Water, that's what we talk about today. So to produce drinking water, often you need water treatment plants. In our exhibit, we show such a water treatment plant to produce pure water, for example, for drinking water purposes. So this could be either a nanofiltration or a reverse osmosis. The difference between reverse osmosis and nanofiltration is that the osmosis removes a higher proportion of dissolved substances in the pure water. So the main principle is that water diffuses under high pressure through a membrane and the ions are retained. But let's have a look at the fluidic scheme of a reverse osmosis plant. So here you see the streams within the pressure vessel. On the left side, you have the raw water, which is the high pressure, high concentration zone, because you want to get out the minerals of the water to get pure water in the end. On the right side, you see the permeate, and the water diffuses directly through the membrane into the direction of the low pressure, low concentration zone of a reverse osmosis plant. On the high pressure side, the concentrate leads directly into the drain. So for example, if you use 100% raw water, you get between 60 to 90% of permeate. In this example, we have 75%. That's the normal recovery, which is designed for those plants. Okay, in real, those plants look like in this project, which was provided by GF. It's a big desalination plant in the Middle East. And here you see a lot of pressure vessels within the stacks. Let's have a deeper look inside and I tell you what GF provided with. So here you see the main headers. We will have a look later at the exhibit to show it in detail, and the pressure vessels with the pure water outlet. GF did the stress analysis, the concept design, and also the design of the supporting structures. We provided with the full valve package, including ball valves, butterfly valves, check valves, the whole process control. Materials were PVCU and PVDF for the chemical side. The whole construction was done by the customizing section and the engineering services of George Fischer. But this leads us back to our exhibit, where we just built the same parts in a smaller size. In our exhibit, we see different pure water outlet variants. For example, you have three-way ball valves, you have T's with two-way ball valves, you have T's with a sample valve. From the pure water outlet, the conductivity of the permeate will be controlled on the sampling board. This sampling board, you have the possibility to control each of the pressure vessels of the complete plant. But there are also other components needed for the control of the plant, of course. For example, butterfly valves, pressure sensors, flow sensors. This is a really good example to see that this can be done even in desalination plants completely full in plastics. Here we have, for example, a butterfly valve, which you will find in the concentrate line, in the permeate line, and in the raw water line. Also, MAC meters, which replace in bigger plants variable area flow meters, can also be found in all the streams of a reverse osmosis plant. So it's recommended to select a full bore MAC meter. In the permeate, depends on the conductivity, if you can use it or not. But if the conductivity is above 20 microsiemens, you can use that MAC meter as well in the permeate line. By monitoring the values and the pressure difference before and after the membrane, the flows, as well as the quality of the different flows, the trained plant technician can see whether there is a problem or not in the plant. Depending on the required final quality of the water, plastics are popular in water treatment plants due to their simple joining technology and favorable properties. As a rule of thumb, one can say the higher the water quality is specified, the higher the quality of the plastic is used. In particular, other industries have specifications where plastics are now permitted or are proving to be more favorable than metal. For example, in the microelectronics industry. This shows that plastic components are perfectly fit for big water treatment plants, even for collecting the permeate in big desalination plants.
Back at it again with another session, or a deep dive session, when it comes to process automation and water treatment, this time with Yannick. Yannick, you can explain to us maybe what this simple looking piece is all about. Now, you told me before, it is simple, but it's definitely full of surprises. And I think your customers are all super excited about it. Why exactly?
Yeah, perfect. Thanks, Chris. So, as you mentioned, it is a simple product, but to make it simple for customers and to make it safety, because it's will make it safe. Mm-hmm. There's more behind it, and we're going to have a look at it later, what's there behind it. And actually, it's a little, it's not a revolution what we did with this 2 years ago, it's rather an evolution. So this is a Ballworth, which was already in the market for around 20 years, mm-hmm. but we enhanced it with certain features to make an easy product, make it a little bit more sophisticated, but also make it more flexible according to demands by our customers.
Interesting, interesting. So once again, this might be simple, might look simple, but there is definitely a bigger story behind it. And when I take a look at this piece, this looks special. What did you do with this?
Right, so this is actually, we call it so-called dead man lever.
Why what, dead man?
What it is, there's actually a funny story behind it, how this was developed. We were at a customer, visiting a customer during our evolution phase. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And actually this customer had a problem, because what happened, he had a manual operation. So he had like a valve like this, and he was dosing. So chemicals were running through while the operator was dosing. Then he got a call, or he went for a smoke, and he forgot to close the valve actually.
Oh no.
Yeah, so the whole chemicals were going through the piping system, and actually a big loss of money and also resources was...
How much money we're talking about?
I think around 2 million euro. Oh. So that is a lot of money.
Because he forgot to close it?
Exactly, exactly. And so this is why we call it a dead man, or a manual spring return unit. So what it does, it's always in the safe position, okay. In the closed position. And once you open it, you can open it for long as you want, as long as you hold the lever. But once you go for a smoke or for a call, it always goes back into the safety position.
Ah, look at that.
So it's basically a safety valve. And I think this customer would have been really happy to have this valve already a couple of years ago.
And I bet that doesn't cost $2 million.
That's right, that's right.
This just shows once again what you can do, once again, with rather simple stuff, but then again enhanced with smart features, as we could see on this one. So when I look at these pieces, and once again, we're talking about simplicity, but it does come down to precision engineering at the end of the day.
Exactly.
Right? When we take a look at the balls inside.
Perfect.
Is that what we're going to see also in the upcoming video?
Exactly. So we're going to see why the heart of the product, the ball itself, or the sphere, is so important, and why processing this piece well mm-hmm. is such a critical factor for customers.
All right. So let's see more about it. You're in the video yourself, so right. No need to introduce. Yannick, here for you.
What looks just like a easy plastic ball actually is one of the most sophisticated parts of one of our core products, and also one of our core products within every water application. It's the heart and soul of our GF ball valves. In this case, we can see a water reverse osmosis application using three different types of GF ball valves. In this case, the ball valve operates as a shutoff valve separating the membrane from the rest of the line. Again, as I mentioned, we have three different types. The three-way ball valve directly connected to the pipe, the two-way ball valve connected via a T-piece, and the sampling ball valve also connected via a T-piece. The advantage of our core ball valves, the 543 and 546 Pro, in comparison to a sampling valve, is the better design, which is safer due to its different sealing concept and also the stronger concept itself. So coming from the application itself, we can see that ball valves are used basically in every water application around the world. Especially our three and two-way ball valve, 546 Pro and 543 are used everywhere where not too many solids are used. So now coming from the application itself, we can have a look at the advantages of the GF ball valves. First of all, our two-way ball valves offer a lockable lever as a standard. So we can see we can lock this valve, so now it's blocked, together with a padlock that's securely locked, either in the open or in the closed position. With the possibility to have an individual labeling on the valve, so at each point of your application you can see, okay, what kind of media is running here, at what temperature, everything as you want, individually you can label it here. Another feature of our ball valves, of our two-way ball valves, is the new double sensor which we designed. What is it? It's a, first of all, you need this compact interface. You add it on the ball valve, use the same standard lever, so again, You can open, close, and lock it as you want. And then with this sensor, you can get electric precision feedback of the ball valve. What you do, you just clip it in, and that's it. Then you connect it with an M12 connector to your PLC or to your system, run the system, and then you get optical position feedback. So either it's open, in this, like in this case, or it's closed. So we have two kinds of lights here. So you get the optical position feedback on the application itself, but also electrically to the positioner. The advantages of this sensor is that it's, yeah, first of all, super compact, easy to use, and one size fits all. This we will see later, but one size fits every dimension, every kind of actuation as well, for the manual ones, for the actuated ones, so we can use only one sensor. It's an inductive sensor, which means in comparison to a mechanical one, we don't have mechanical friction here, which guarantees a way longer lifetime of the inductive double sensor. And another feature is that we have the IP67 rating, so you can throw it into dust and water without problem. As I mentioned, we can use the sensor also on our actuated valves. So for example, in this case, we would actuate our manual ball valve. Again, we can use the same sensor for every size, for every dimension. Another new feature of our ball valve family is the so-called dead man lever, or a manual spring return unit. What it does, it's always in the closed, in the safety position, like in this case. And once you open it manually, you have to keep your hand like this. And once you take your hand away, it goes back into the safety position. So this is, again, it's a safety feature, it's a safety valve. This kind of valve is used also, again, in every application where you need safe sampling, dosing, and cleaning. So where you have to operate the valve only for a couple of seconds every day or once in a while, then this is the perfect solution. It's also a compact and a very reliable solution. Of course, there are always people, we're all humans, we're all lazy, we don't want to keep our hand like this the whole time, so we find ways to block the valve. We cannot prevent this, but we can use, again, the same sensor, put it in here, and you will get the electrical position feedback of the state of this individual valve. So for example, we imagine it is installed here, a manual spring return unit, and you will get the position feedback. Okay, is it open or is it closed to your PLC? So you can run this whole system without being at the system itself with this precision feedback. All of these features I just talked about, these we use on our 546 Pro Bowers. It's our flagship, it's our core product, our core ball valve. So there we have the whole options, the whole range of modularity and accessories. But of course, there are also processes and applications where you only need a simple shut on and off valve, which works perfectly fine. And therefore, we created the so-called 542 ball valve. There's the same installation length, but it does not offer the options and accessories as the 546 Pro. But again, if you decide today I need only a manual valve in this place of my system, you can go ahead with the 542. And afterwards, if you decide I do need actuation, no problem. You just change the interface, the central part, and then change it to the 546 Pro. And here again, you have the options to modularity build it from here. With our 546 ball valves, what we also offer is a so-called data matrix code. It's similar to a QR code. It offers a lot of information on the valve. It's a unique code, so this code is printed on the valve body after the testing in our factory in Switzerland. So if we pass all the tests with this single valve, you will get all technical information are stored on this data matrix code. So again, this is a safety feature for you as a customer, because you know, if I get this data matrix code, I can be sure that this valve left our plant tested, fully tested, and without any problems. We offer our GF ball valve in the whole range of dimensions and materials. So either from a small DN10 valve to bigger ones, the DN100, and all different kinds of valve ends, from backing flanges to simple sockets and so on. In all different kinds of standards and in five different materials, PVCU, PVCC, ABS, PPH, and PVDF. So again, with our ball valves, we find a solution for every application, every problem that occurs in plastic piping. To summarize all of this, we can see the modularity of our ball valves. So we have the options, as I talked about before, of a simple manual ball valve. We have the option of an electrical position feedback, of a dead man lever, and also all kinds of actuation, from pneumatic to electric actuators. All possible with our ball valves. Everything is modular, everything works pretty well. But as I mentioned in the beginning, the core piece and soul of all of our ball valves is the ball itself. Looks like a simple product, but actually it's one of the most sophisticated plastic products which we have in our ball valves. And yeah, but this is not the end for our ball valve family. Stay tuned. What we do with our ball valve portfolio, we will enhance it, we will get stronger and bigger. So yeah, stay tuned what we will offer here.
So let's continue with the star of the show, the champion in the ring, the reason we're all here together, the butterfly valve. And Jochen will tell us a bit more about this. What's so special about it, Jan?
Yeah, so the special thing in the process automation skid for the butterfly valve is that it's often used in combination with the different actuators. Also, we offer, and that's very important for process automation, we offer a double sensor which can be installed directly in the valve.
All right, sounds good. But maybe you can tell us a bit more about the history of it. Like, who came up with the idea? Why did you develop this?
So the idea came basically from a customer interview. Mm-hmm. We do here design thinking together with customers. And they ask us, hey, why you are not offering mm-hmm. a butterfly valve in the same installation length made out of plastic than the metal competitors in the market?
Okay.
And that's not so easy. And so far, plastic butterfly valves are thicker. Uh-huh. But with this new development, the butterfly valve type 565, we achieve the same installation length as the metal counterparts in the market.
Okay, I understand why it's considered a revolution there. Yeah. But maybe you can tell us a bit more about the, you know, the development of this product. How long did it take to develop?
Actually, the customer interview is quite a time ago, maybe 5 to 6 years.
Wow, yeah. Why so long?
Like, yeah, so it's not really easy to produce or to develop a product like this mm-hmm. because we wanted to combine different requirements, so from the water treatment market and also from the marine market, into one product. Mm. And at the same time, only one material combination shall cover all these needs. And that's the reason why it took quite a while to develop this new champion in the ring, but now here it is, so everybody's happy.
Well, obviously it was worth the effort and also worth it for the valve, because you know what, this valve has its own shirt series, ladies and gentlemen. And when I talk about shirt series, why don't you turn around and show them what I mean there. See that? Now, when you have your own t-shirt, you know you made it. So this valve is definitely on the rise, we could say. And you're probably going to get some inquiries from your clients asking, where can I get the shirt?
But more to that. Just call me.
That's a different topic. But anyway, what are we going to see in the video now? You're going to go into detail about this valve, right?
Yes, how it's useful or how it's made the reverse osmosis kit for our customer more efficient than ever before.
All right. Well, excited to see what you have to say. So without any further ado, enjoy the video.
In the gym, you want to challenge you every day with the highest possible weights. But in your daily working business, you want to work smarter and not harder. And with our new Butterfly Valve 565, we have the smartest solution on the market. Here in the skid, the valve is used as an on-off valve with the smart actuator on top of it. It can be also be used for blocking, regulating, and controlling operations. The valve ensures the hydraulic balance in the system, which can react very sensitive to fluctuation in the various lines. The new valve can everywhere be used where not critical medium and water need to be transported. This could be in aquariums, in swimming pools, in wastewater systems, in life support, in marine, like shipbuilding, in desalination plants, or even in cooling application. The Type 565 is excellent for use with gravel, multi-layer and activated carbon filters. Other applications are softening and ultrafiltration plants. Also a potential application are distribution lines for process water. The new solution impressed with a very modular design. The most frequent valves, which be used as a shut-off butterfly valve, are pneumatic actuated ones, with mainly the failure close and failure open function being used. But we also offer our electric actuator valve and our smart electric actuator valve. We offer a hand wheel, a reduction gear, our lever solution, and additional, we offer the accessory of a double sensor for electrical feedback. How would I rate the new generation of butterfly valves in membrane plants? For me, the new plastic butterfly valve fits perfectly into the design of water treatment plants. With a high pressure rating of 16 bar and the same installation length as metal butterfly valves, it has the additional advantage of being 60% lighter than metal valves. The high technology disc design and material has even more advantages. With the smooth surface and the low migration rates of substances, it is perfectly suitable with regard to hygiene requirements for pure water from desalination plants. In which other application does the plastic butterfly valve 565 in the field of water treatment deliver customer benefits? In simple water treatment plants whose specifications are not in the high-end range, or in pre-treatment stages of ultra-pure water or pharmaceutical water. Especially for the replacement of metal butterfly valves, the Type 565 fits perfectly. Why should you change from a metal valve to a plastic solution? The advantage of weight of the valve not only affects the fastening concept, it also enables a much easier replacement with less manpower due to low weight. In addition, the plastic disc cannot rust, which not only prevents the mechanical damage, but also prevents the water from rust contamination. To sum up, we have here the smartest solution on the market. We have here the butterfly valve 565 as a new champ in the ring, which can challenge his counterparts in every round.
Now, I gotta tell you, I've learned a lot so far, but we're not finished yet. There's more to come. And that brings me to the Smart E-Actuator and Philip, who can explain us what this actually does, what it's good for. So Philip, first of all, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Great to have you. So take us on the journey through the so-called Smart E-Actuator. Are these devices I see here on the table all E-actuators, or what are we looking at here?
Those are pneumatic actuators, mm-hmm. but also electric actuators. Mm-hmm. So we're covering both within our product range, depending on the application. Butterfly valves, but also ball valves, are either actuated pneumatically or electrically. Mm-hmm. And the smart actuator specifically is like a special version of our electric standard actuator. Mm-hmm. We call them EA15 to EA250.
Okay.
The number stands for the maximum torque
okay.
we apply on the different sizes of the valves. And
so that's customizable, basically.
It's customizable. So it ranges of small valve, small actuator, big valve, big actuator.
Pretty simple. Okay. Yeah. And this, you said, is the smart one. What about that one?
This is the standard range, so that's the one you get pre-assembled from the factory. Mm-hmm. So if customers usually 90% they purchase their valve pre-assembled mm-hmm. from the factory, that's where we use this one.
Okay.
Because we take the effort to assemble everything and make sure it works. That's, let's say, the high runner mm-hmm. we put on every valve, mm-hmm. Ball valves, but also all types of butterfly valves we are selling. So simple, economical, flexible platform. It's highly adjustable to your application needs mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. In terms of interfaces, feedback contacts, and so on.
So what are the advantages, though, when you opt for the smart version?
With the smart version, it took us a bit on a journey. So we traveled around the world. Mm-hmm. We visited a lot of customers trying to figure out, when it comes to electrical actuation, what are the challenges in making things work, during the commissioning process and so on, but also diagnostics and maintenance, troubleshooting and so on. So that's where we gathered a lot of insights from the customer side and try to implement solutions in a software app, which is available on for tablets and mobile phones. And it basically allows you to interact through Wi-Fi with your mobile phone with the electric actuator, making things more easy, commissioning, but also you get more insights, looking at performance data and so on.
To see what's actually going on inside. And I suppose these work perfectly together, looking at the valve over here and the e-actuator over there.
Yes.
Like, how does this go together when we're talking about process automation?
Yeah, so there are two ways. So it's physically, we try to make things more easy. So it comes with a standard physical interface. So they basically fit on top of each other easily, but that's just the one way. The other way is once you have to, where's my mobile phone? There it is. you have to basically marry the electric actuator onto the valve, so they have to find each other, and that's where the application, like our mobile app, comes into play, which basically allows you to align the positions of the actuator onto the valve disc perfectly without opening the electric actuator.
So it's kind of like a love story. They definitely like each other, right?
Well, that was the plan.
Okay, so in the upcoming video, we're basically going to see some more details about what role the e-actuator plays in process automation in general, right?
Yes.
And you're going to be the host.
I'm going to be the host. I'm going to show you through some of the main features from the app, but also show you some of the accessories which are available within this product range, not only for the smart, but also the standard. And yeah, looking forward to explain you a bit more about that.
Well, then let's check it out. The easy way, of course.
I guess everyone or you already had a look at his iPhone, smartwatch, whatever you're using, what kind of smart devices you're using. At least multiple times a day, you look at this, looking for news. For many people, it's an instrument of to become more efficient and make things more easy. For others, it's a piece of distraction. For us, it's the first thing. We like to make things more easy and more transparent. Therefore, we have applied a new technology or a new connectivity board to one of our electric actuators, which is installed here in this reverse osmosis system. It allows you to connect with your mobile phone through Wi-Fi or through NFC simply by touching the electric actuator to retrieve basic information about the valve performance or product information. Electric actuated valves you find in reverse osmosis systems or multiple places. They're frequently in use to keep the set point on the best possible balance to make the overall operation as efficient as possible. So they continuously control the pressure inside of the system before and after the membranes. We use this device to learn more about the actuated valves in such kind of systems, but even more demanding applications where you have chemical abrasion working on ceilings, on the valves, in order to understand how valves change throughout the lifetime within the system. We also utilize this piece of device, this instrument, to learn about performance data in our test lab. So during the development of this new butterfly valve, we frequently applied our smart version of the actuator also in our own laboratories in order to make sure that we, during the development process, where we test those kind of valves up to 250,000 of cycles, that we understand how they change the performance over lifetime while applying chemicals, while applying different pressures during the test phase to make sure what we're going to launch to the market really hits the high quality standards of GF piping systems. Now, what's so special to connect your mobile phone to an electrically actuated valve? It allows you to see data which currently is hidden. It's in a black box. So if your valve fails, you never really know what's going on. Also throughout the long lifetime or throughout the long time of operation, you don't know how things change, for example, the condition of ceilings around the discs or like directly to the shaft. You don't know how chemicals or different pressures have an effect, a negative effect on the performance of your valve. This type of device, once you have connected, gives you a nice overview of the current condition of your valve. It's a nice dashboard showing you the current position of the valve, but also it's giving you the opportunity to take and also re-evaluate a fingerprint of this particular valve you have just installed. The way how it works, once it's installed and you install in a system, you use your app, you connect to the electric actuator, we set the baseline, that's what we call the fingerprint. So once it's installed, initially we read how the valve behaves in the new condition, from open to close, from close to open, and we save this as a fingerprint. So we are reading the motor current in order to understand how it actually moves in new condition. So as you can see, it can be very beneficial to connect your mobile device to an electric actuator in order to understand how the valve behaves. Of course, it's not mandatory, and we also offer our electric actuator range without connectivity boards to mobile devices as a standard. We're using these kind of actuators basically for all GF rotary valves, whether it's a ball valve, different butterfly valves, but even diaphragm valves. So it's not only rotary valves, we also have the ability to control diaphragm valves. It's possible because we are using a standard physical interface. And of course, we're not only limited to GF valves, you can connect to any other third-party valve as well. They come in different sizes, from small Torx, 25 newton meter, all the way up to 250 newton meters. And therefore, it's a flexible, very flexible product range covering basically all the needs within actuated valves. We're not only flexible in terms of connecting different valves physically, we're also flexible in connecting to control systems, PLCs, controllers, and so on. So therefore, we applied modular design. You simply can use different kind of PCBs to be plugged into your electric actuator in order to connect to interfaces such as Profibus, Modbus RTU control systems, but also just simple current-controlled flow loops. So for example here, to make sure you always hit the right pressure set point, you continuously would modulate the butterfly valve to the perfect set point. With the current input, for example, you simply take one of these current boards, plug it in, connect to your PLC, tune the loop, start the operation. There are also other options. For example, if you only have open-close applications, which are also very frequently used on butterfly valves and water applications, we have a different kind of module which allows you not only to run open and close as different as certain conditions, but also to adjust the cycle time of a valve. It's not too important for small butterfly valve, but if you go big in size, you go big in pressure, you have to reduce, for example, the cycle time to reduce the risk of water hammers within your systems. Therefore, also you can apply this kind of module, simply plug it in, tune the cycle time according to the requirements of your overall piping system and make sure you're on the safe side of things. Beside this, for very critical valves where you want to make sure, even in case of a blackout, you want to make sure they maintain a fail-safe position, GF Piping System also is offering a battery module which is integrated into the main body of the electric actuator, which allows the EA, the electric actuator, to move into fail-safe position even if there's no voltage applied anymore. So very compact, inside of the housing, no external batteries, another module, and as you can see, you can basically modify the complete setup to your application requirements. So as you can see, the product range of electric actuators from GF Piping Systems is very versatile and highly customizable. You can customize your own electric interface, you can adjust the different characteristics like valve speeds and so on by adding different modules to your electric actuator. You can use this product range on every rotary GF valve. And also, just to top it up, we also have the smart version to connect with your mobile phone if you're really keen to learn more about your systems on how the valves behave, for example, in your reverse osmosis system.
Now it's time for Flotramag. And no, this is not a transformer we're talking about. I'm pretty sure you experts out there know exactly what I mean. A fantastic product from GF Piping Systems. And Flo can tell us more about it. But first, Flo, great to have you on the show.
Thank you for having me here.
And maybe you could tell us, before we actually talk about the product, what you actually do at GF.
Yeah, I'm product manager for the European market. Mm-hmm. So I'm one of the first results of a strategic decision 2 years ago.
Okay.
with our instrumentation products, we are very good on the US market, have a good statement there, mm-hmm. and also in the Chinese market. Mm-hmm. On the European market, we haven't got the foot into the market yet.
And that's
too
what
much.
You're there for.
And that's the reason why I'm here, yes, exactly. Two things are important. Push our products into the market mm-hmm. and also develop the right products for the market. So these are the both things I do.
And you talked about the American colleagues.
Exactly. We are a global company. Right. The production company of our instrumentation, of most of our instrumentation, is settled in California. Mm-hmm. And there we have a couple of colleagues, PM colleagues, which are doing the factory PM work, which is done. And I'm more on the sales side and also on the specification side, and have a close work together. Yeah.
All right. Nice to know what you do. Now let's talk about what the device actually does, also in the context of process automation. What is a Flowtramac good for?
Flowtramac is basically a flow meter. Mm-hmm. Flow is the most measured parameter probably in the world. So at least in all the flow skids and flow piping systems. The Flowtramac measures the flow with a Mach meter technology. Mm-hmm. So that is also what all our competition does, or all the products on the market. As mentioned, flow is everywhere.
Right. So what differentiates you from the competitors?
We have a full plastic version of a Mach meter. So we have a full bore Mach meter. Competition has all, or sometimes, or mostly a metal Mach meter.
Right.
Housing is metal. Sometimes when it comes to chemicals, a plastic liner inside. Our product is complete plastic.
Right.
Also outside. So, and fits perfect in our piping system.
And once again, this
That's
is one
the
of the core competencies
yeah.
of GF. Now, you were talking about this piece, which is basically, I guess, the standard kind of device you would install, or what are we looking at here exactly?
Exactly, yes. We have, as mentioned, a long history of competence in instrumentation. Mm-hmm. We started with our insertion Mach meter and insertion pedal wheel, other parameters which mm-hmm. are possible to measure. And we have a standard fitting, standard installation fitting. This fits into all of our piping systems.
Okay.
So that's a product which is really core for us.
And that makes it more flexible, right?
That makes it flexible, exactly. With that Mach meter, this size can fit into different dimension of piping systems. So just changing the fitting, which is compared to the flow meter, low cost. Mm-hmm. So you can have different sizes on stock and use the same Mach meter for different dimension, what you need probably as in your products or in your installation.
Right.
So that's where we're coming from. This installation can be used for different parameter. But we recognized on the market that that flow full bore Mach meter, mm-hmm. which is some kind of standard, mm-hmm. We get more requests for that. So
okay.
And then we started to develop this product 2 years ago,
okay.
Or even more. With a difference that we have some advantages in installation length, so that we can put it in smaller skids and things like that.
So this is also basically customizable.
This is also customizable,
right.
But the difference is you can use one product for one dimension, mm-hmm. what's standard on the market, mm-hmm. use it there also in a very small installation phase. So short inlet and outlet section. So this is important for this product. And this is where we recognize that we need to go there. We started development on the first release 2 years ago, mm-hmm. had a new release just now, mm-hmm. With some updated new dimensions. Mm-hmm. So good portfolio now, that's ready to go.
And that's what we're gonna see in the video, which of course is hosted by yourself, right?
Yes. By my-
so let's check out more details about Flowtramac right now. Here we go.
Have you used Google, Wikipedia, or a book to look something up this week? Why? You don't know something and it could have an influence on your action. That's the reason. Measurement is knowing. If you don't measure, you cannot choose the right action. As Wikipedia is often okay as a knowledge base, it is not in every situation the right choice. Sometimes it needs to be a big reference book. This is the same for measurement applications. We also develop instrumentation for plastic pipes. As you can see here on this reverse osmosis system, we have, for example, a pressure sensor. This pressure sensor is built in on the low pressure side and is a very important value to lead the process. Also, it helps here to ensure in the operation to stay in the pressure requirements of the components. Also, we have here a conductivity sensor. Especially on this reverse osmosis kit is that we have a conductivity sample board. This helps to sample values from each of the membranes and find out if one of the membranes has a problem and we need to react. In the middle of the skid, we have a flow sensor. In this case, a full bore magnetic flow sensor. This is very important for the hydraulic balance of the filtration system. Gives the controller the knowledge about the difference between permeate stream and rejection stream. This shows the efficiency of the process and gives also a first indication if something goes wrong. The floater mech can also be used everywhere where we have plastic pipes or where we have chemical effects on a material. It needs at least a 20 millisiemens conductivity and is perfect for ultra nano filtration systems and for chemical processing. On the slide behind me, you can see already the new generation. This is available from now. We upgraded the outer housing and added dimensions. The main benefit is the highly reliable PVC body. This helps you inside and also on the outside if there are chemicals. It fits perfect in our PVC system and also with a PE union end into the PE system. With a short inlet and outlet section, we fit perfectly also in narrowly built skids. The full bore design reduces pressure loss, and this helps you in the design cost for your skid. The P4C body has another major advantage. Compared to a metal mech meter in the same dimension, it is 2/3 lighter than this. This form, your installation guy will be happy because it's more convenient in handling. Also on the cost side, it helps you because you don't need additional support structure, which is also costs and time in the installation. And also the same reduced complexity than our other PVC systems. The smart function of the floater mech help you in the field. The GF commissioning app helps you to commission the floater mech guided in the field, entering all values in the right amount, easily done for you. The live view of the parameters here helps you if you need to see the values and the mech meter is built in on the other side. It's like a mobile display. If you need to track something or to data log values, parameters, that's easily done with the app and can be sent out via phone or iPad to the colleagues they needed. Calibration on the site is done via app as well. All in the app, all what you need. To measure right, it's very important to not damage the expensive membranes. This for we have with the floater mech the perfect solution. It fits perfect into our piping system and is now available in 5 dimensions from DN25 to DN100. Also with both FKM and ETBM O-ring and with Hesteloy C and titanium electrodes. That fit perfect for your water treatment installation.
So I hope I didn't promise too much. Talk about a fantastic deep dive session. And I'd like to thank you all. Once again, you guys did a great job, our experts here in the field. And I think now it's time to wrap it up. So Jochen, process automation in general, what's it about? What do I need it for?
Yes. Process automation combines the different elements of measurement, actuation, and valves. And with our solutions from GF, customization for each project, for each customer project is possible.
Sounds good. Flo, give us the wrap-up of a measurement.
Measurement, if you want to control something automatically, you need to know the value. So the measurement needs to be done. In our case, we spoke about flow measurement. If you know the flow speed, you can control it.
Moving on to actuation, Philip.
Once you know the flow, you can control it using different types of actuators, whether it's pneumatic or electric. and even different versions of electric actuators, standard or even smart ones to make things more easy.
I like that rhyme at the beginning, by the way. And then, last but not least, valves by Yannick.
Yeah, these different type of actuators we put on our safe and reliable valves, if it's butterfly valves, ball valves, or diaphragm valve.
And yes, this was a deep dive session. Nevertheless, not enough time to really go into the verticals, all right? We're still scratching the surface here, and as you can imagine, there's much more to come. So if you want to know more, just get in contact with GF at any time. And stay tuned for more to come in the future, because as you can imagine, this was definitely not the final round when it comes to process automation.